This year, we really flipped over this team.
He's been my teammate ever since sixth grade, and I can't remember a time when there was a big shot that needed to be taken from outside. He's the one you give the ball to. He's an excellent shooter and one of the most competitive guys you'll ever play with. This year he meant a lot to our team. He's been a shooter his whole life, and this year he kind of took one for the team, doing us a favor, and became our point guard, which we really needed a point guard. And he did a great job bringing the ball up this year and helped us out a lot in that area. And still was able to use his shooting as a strong point as well. And it's been fun playing with him ever since sixth grade. I can remember in ninth grade, three of our teammates left us alone, three starters. And everyone thought we weren't going to win anything. And we ended up winning the championship that year. And it was like that a lot this year, too, where we're the only two seniors on the team, and a couple guys left the team, and, but we stuck through, and I couldn't think of anyone else I'd rather stick through it, than Andy.
Amendere, back to Vladkovic, top of the key to Vertanen. Kevin Kopp getting the breather right now, by the way. Gets it over to Skrako for three, and he drove it.
During my playing days at Canfield High School, I played with a lot of good teammates, but none better than Kevin Culp. Kevin's been a great leader for us, and this year was no different. He really did a great job. He's our leading scorer, and he's our leading rebounder. And during a lot of big games, he stepped up big. I remember during the Stros game in the second half, he had some great moves that he just really got the crowd into it, and that was great for Kevin and I to play in a game that big. But you know, I played with Kevin since sixth grade, and all the way up through, you know, us two, you know, we've been kind of like a little team. Like, it was always known as Kevin and Andy. I'm glad that I had a partner to run with, because I know this year it would have been tough if I didn't have him. He led us through so many tough times, and there were some games late in the year where he carried us through them. And if we didn't have him in some of those games where some of us were struggling, I don't think we would have won the MAC title. But he's just done it. He did a great job all year. And I can't think of anybody else I'd rather play with. He's just a great player and a great leader, and he's very unselfish, and he really improved. He really improved from last year. He was always a good scorer, but this year I noticed he was a good, very good passer, and they weren't like flashy passes or anything, but he always found the open man because he knew he was drawing a lot of attention to himself. He just did a great job of getting people involved, and that's pretty uncharacteristic from most big men.
Pass to Sadie. Anthony almost lost it. Gets it over to Kopp for three. Got it. 38 for Kevin Kopp. It's leaving. Kevin Kopp hits the front end. He has 39. Standing ovation for Vladkovic. He gets his 40th point. Yes, he did. He has 40. He's out of there. They'll get a standing ovation. Flirting 40 tonight, and he's out of the ball game with Canfield 78-52 lead. And they're still giving him an ovation, even though the play has resumed.
Parents' night was probably the most memorable night for us because it was the last time we'll ever cheer at the high school. It was really special to see all the looks on the parents' faces. They seemed really proud of their kids. And it was especially nice because we played a great game and beat Nile. It's been such a pleasure cheering for such a wonderful team this year. The biggest game I feel this year was the second time we played Struthers, because we really showed them what Canfield was all about, and because we tied for the MAC. It seemed like we were playing a football game at the time.
There's no need. This is my third year announcing for the Cards. It's been a great honor. It was one of my biggest dreams when I was young. Just looking up to John Curtley because he was the man. I wanted to do it because he was just so awesome. And it was just an honor and a privilege. I'd like to thank Coach Kahn for giving me the opportunity and Mr. Weiss because it was just so much fun to announce for my boys. They were a great team all 3 years. Great kids, nicest kids I know. They took me in. I mean, I did everything with them. It was just awesome. Like most people who think the Struthers game two is probably the best highlight of the year, I think that the Cardinal mascot was the best thing. What a great looking guy.
You know what this looks like? It's like you guys have been watching the QVC channel way too long.
You're unbelievable.
Well, they go to 53, what do we like? That place, they go to 54, we're on Westbrook. Now read where you're throwing. I read where you're throwing to see if they're playing hard or soft. They're playing soft, get the right people in there, just throw it back, we'll play down, release up that way. Finish when you get down there, and don't, and take your time, and make a quick decision without the board covering down there. Okay, thank you, that's the ball. Bring it out, Mr. Ball. And get to the line. And put yourself in good positions. We need to put ourselves in good positions to pass the ball.
My first teaching job and coaching job was at Brookfield High School, where I was the ninth grade coach for 1 year. Then I was the JV coach for the next 4 years, and in all five of those years, our varsity, which I was a big part of, went to the regionals. So I thought that's how things were supposed to be. I thought everybody went to the regionals, and so I had that kind of background, that kind of experience, and among probably some of the finest athletes this area has ever produced, there was at least five major college Division I athletes in that little school when I was there for those 5 years. And then I took my first head job at Kinsman Badger I believe it was 1977-78, and there was a skinny little kid that was a freshman there who ended up making the Los Angeles Lakers and ended up quitting. But we didn't have very much talent, and I started four sophomores, and I learned what humility was. We went 1-20. I lost my sense of humor and just about every other admirable quality that I could possess. But I learned probably more about coaching that year than I did any other year. And then after that year, I knew we were going to be pretty good the following year because we had everybody coming back. But the Brookfield, which you know was a big part of my life because I'd been to five regionals with them, they came back and said if I would come back and take the job there, that they wouldn't even open it up for interviews. So I went back there, and for the next 3 years, I went back to I coached at Brookfield, and we had a positive experience there also, but we had very little experience, and we went to the district finals once and the district semis another time, so we had we still had a good tradition build up there, but just not the same level of talent. And then in summer of 1982, I'm watching an Indians game, and Tom Titus, who was the coach at Canfield, came and recruited me, said he was going into business, and he wanted me. He had a nice team coming back, and he wanted to leave with somebody that he trusted. So he brought me to Canfield, and I got the job there in 1982-83, and we won the league championship our first year and had a nice record. And since then, it's been awfully good experience for us. I think we've won 11 league championships and been to the regionals four times. And more importantly than that, we've just been associated with some wonderful, wonderful people in terms of, the people in the community and the school personnel, but mainly the players. When you think back on the whole thing, it's the relationships and the players that you had that really made it special.
What did it feel like winning your 300th game this year?
Well, when you go into education, which these guys are going to have to figure out, Andy and Kevin will have to figure out, it's you have to decide what kind of avenues you want to reach for in your life. And I had to decide whether I wanted to be, rich, which obviously it wasn't one of my choices, becoming a teacher, whether or not I wanted to become famous. And as a high school coach, you're not going to become famous. I wanted to be somebody that was looked up to among my peers as one of the better coaches in the area. So therefore, from the time I started until now, I've tried to become a student of the game and of education, trying to become the best teacher, because coaching is the purest form of teaching, because it's the only place you can teach and everybody really wants to be there all the time. And also, it allows you to keep that competitive spirit burning that I've had ever since I've been a youngster. Since that time, I can't say that I really ever thought, boy, I want to get to 300. But the longer you're in it, you look at the people that are in that club, and you say, wow, that's pretty special. And look at what those kind of people have achieved. And it's hard to look at yourself like that. But I looked at those people and I said, I'd like to be like one of them someday. And I think probably more than anything else, it just means that you stood the test of time and were consistent.
Guys, Gator, you got two fouls, so a good job there. You can't afford to be getting a third foul because he's out of control. Just get down nice and low and get a stance. Nice job, that's the way to go. Come on, guys, let's go. Work, Krager. How'd he get inside of you there? Easy entrance. Let's go. Rescreen motion. Nice shape up right there. Come on, guys. Let's go, Krager. Don't let your feet come together. Come on, Z. That's no challenge. You didn't challenge that pass at all. Good job there. Hey, challenge that pass. Hey, Z, be in position to get a bluff on a pass here. Come on, let's go. Where was that, this guy? Come on, Strox. Work, Z, work. Help him. Good job. Watch the second hand coming to the ball. Good hand. Let's go. Jam into the bottom of the rim. Stay with him, Al. Stay with him. Good job, Al. Let's go. Kick. Give it to him. Knucklehead, what are you doing? That's the one. Good screen. Hey, we're not getting the inside screens. One pass away, we gotta go get people. Use me, get me.
The Canfield Cardinals 1998-99 basketball season. There were many interesting challenges, a couple of heartbreakers, and some major accomplishments. These included finishing with a fantastic 19-4 record, sharing the Metro Athletic Conference crown, knocking off previously unbeaten Struthers Wildcats by a substantial margin, winning the sectional crown, breaking the school record for most points scored by one player in a single game, and Coach John Collins' 300th victory.
Y'all ready for this?
Now,
In the season opener against Warren Harding, the Cardinals score the first 5 points and never look back. In this contest, Coach Frank Buba from Harding said, "Canfield is a great team. They'll do well. They forced us to lose our composure a lot." Culp averaged 18 points last season, but finished the game with nearly double that. He scored 34, while Vladkovic added 17, Alex Amendolea, Herman, and Scrocco had two each, and Zach Amendolea finished with five. Canfield shot 41% from the field and 79% from the line, while their sticky defense held Harding to only 32% from the field. Coach Collins said it was a great honor playing in this Division I environment and a great victory to open the season. In the Cardinals' second contest, Vodatkovich and Kopp combined for 41 points. However, the key to this victory was our ability to shut down Lakeview's offense for two quarters, Collins said. In the final two stanzas, Lakeview was held to only 18 points. What a great defensive game by the entire Canfield roster. Vodatkovich finished with 25 points, including 4 3-pointers, while Kopp added 16. Alex Amendola had 6, his brother Zach had 5, and Herman, Sadie, and Scrocco added 2 each.
Yeah.
In game number three against Mooney, Canfield received tremendous balance from the bench. Collins said, "Our bench stepped up and didn't just give the starters a rest, but really hurt the other team with some great plays." Canfield shot 61% from the field and built a 52-34 lead by the end of the third quarter. Once again, the Cardinal defense held Mooney to only 21 points in the final two quarters. Kopp finished with 17, Vladkovich with 15 on 3 3-pointers. Marks added 8, Sadie 7, Vertanen, Herman, and Zach Mendeleya added 6 each. Alex had 2, and Hoya added 1. And then the 3-0 Cardinals were on the road with crosstown rival the Struthers Wildcats. Both teams were undefeated. Both teams were ready to do battle. It was quite a seesaw struggle all the way. Canfield fell behind early 12-5 after the first quarter, but the Cardinals bounced back to tie the score 25 at the half. This Metro Athletic Conference game seemed like a game of inches on the football field at times. The fans got their money's worth. At the end of three, it was still tied 39-all. Once again, a tremendous defensive showing by the Cardinals. Only one player was in double figures for Struthers. In this one, Canfield shredded the Nets for 7 3-pointers. Culp had three, Sadie had two, and Scrocco and Zach Amendola had one each. Culp, the leading scorer, finished with 18, and Vladkovich with 10.
Thank you.
The fifth tilt was against Boardman. The Cardinals found themselves in another hard-fought battle, just like Struthers. But they weren't about to let this one get away. The Spartans jumped out to a 14-12 lead at the end of one and 27-24 at the half. The much taller Spartans were no match for the Cardinals, though. Their fortitude prevailed. Once again, the defense stepped in and held Boardman to only 8 points in the fourth quarter. The Cardinals had three men in double figures, Kalp 18, Vladkovich with 18, and Sadie with 10. The Cardinals pulled this one out in a crowd pleaser, 54-53.
Thank you.
6 was scheduled against Hickory, but was canceled because of inclement weather. Canfield was rested and ready for the Girard Indians. They forced Girard to turn the ball over 25 times. They also forced the Indians to shoot from outside. Girard was only 7 of 23 from three-point range. And once again, a very stubborn Cardinal defense kept Girard under their thumb. At the half, it was 37 to 18 Cardinals. Girard only tallied 3 points in the second quarter. Kopp finished with 13 and Vladkovich and Sadie with 11 apiece. It was the best performance yet for Skronko and Marks, who each added 7. Herman finished with 8. Amandaria, Vertanen, 4, and Hoya with 2. The final, Canfield 67, Girard 52. Canfield 7 contest turned out to be another tough one against Poland. But the real deciding factor in the contest was at the free throw line. Canfield finished with 18 of 26, or 70% of their fouls. The defense held the Bulldogs to only 8 points in the third quarter. Scores were Vladkovich with 21, Kopp 18, Sadie 13, Craig Marks with eighth, Zach and Alex Amendaria, Scrocco, Vertanen, and Herman each added 2 points apiece. The final on this one, Canfield 68, Poland 57. Contest against the Quakers turned out to be no contest. But Salem would improve during the season and look for revenge at their next meeting. The bench did a great job in this one, too. Joel Vertanen finished with 10. Adam Schuster added 4. Zach and Alex Amendaria, 8 each. Kevin Kalp, 15. Anthony Sadie, Andy Vladkovic, and Herman had 6 apiece. Marks and Scrocco added 2 points each. The final in this one, Canfield 63, Salem 44.
Zach Amendaria with the assist from Kevin. Zach Amendaria.
Turned out to be another defensive stand-up. The Cardinals' defense held Nowes to only 4 or 5 buckets a quarter. Let's watch.
Yeah.
In Game 10, Canfield found themselves against the powerful Canton Central Catholic team. The Green Machine went to work out rebounding the Cardinals in every stanza. Even though Kalpin Sadie canned 13 and Andy Vladkovich added 12, the Cardinals still went down to defeat by a score of 62-49. Allen struggled all year. This contest was no exception. Collin was able to use all the players in this one as Canfield breezed by the Tigers 72-38.
Yeah.
And then what many called the Mahoning Valley game of the year, the grudge match against the Struthers Wildcats. Struthers came into this one still undefeated at 10-0. But Canfield came prepared this time, prepared for the grueling physical matchup that would find both teams spending much of the time wrestling for the ball on the hardwoods. But when this one was all over, the Wildcats fans were silenced. McFadden, who had 25 in the first tilt, was held to just 16. This was certainly a well-coached game. Collin used the box and won all night. He didn't get the easy looks he got in the first game, Collin said, as he praised the Cards in the locker room. Scores, Vladkovich with 21, Kalp had 15, D'Amato 3, Sadie 12, Alex and Zach Amendola at 2, Mike Herman with 8, and Craig Marks added 3. This was a fantastic victory for the Cardinals. They were now tied for the Metro Athletic Conference lead. The fans were phenomenal in this one. Canfield was now 10-2.
Thank you.
The next game was away against West Branch. The Cardinals poured in a 10-point lead after the first quarter and never looked back. Miladkovic had 15, Kalp 13, Zach Amendola 10, Mike Herman had 10, Marks had 10, Schuster and Sadie 3 apiece, Vertanen with 8, Scrocco, Amendola, and Palma 2 each, and Julia finished with 4. The final, Canfield 79, West Branch 56.
Yeah!
The second time against Girard, it went much the same as the first time. No resistance, no pressure. It was a tune-up for tough for things to come. Sirocco shot a season-high 11, and the team leader was Vladkovic, who finished with 20. The final, Canfield 68, the Indians 37.
Yeah, 30.
The next up was against the Division I power, Austin Tan Fitch, but also a battle against the flu bug. Latkovich was one who took a breather after one quarter and did not return after that. Once again, the team pulled together and performed against all odds. The Cardinals were down 10 late in the fourth quarter. As fate would have it, Kevin Culp ripped the nets with 5 seconds remaining to send the game into overtime. Deadlocked at 52-all, the Cardinals began an uphill battle. Even though Culp finished with 25 and Alex Amendola with 12, it just wasn't enough. "We had some inexperienced kids in there and they poured their hearts out," said Cullen. The final was a heartbreaker and only the Cardinals' third defeat of the year. The final, the Falcons 60, the Cardinals 56 in overtime.
Comes into Culp in the post, turns and fades away and nails it from 8 feet. So Kevin Culp starts off with a hoop in the second half of play. As Culp gets to Marks. Marks pushes it into the front court. Marks between the circles. Marks gets the basketball off to the left wing to Vertana. Quick pass comes underneath and Alex Amendola puts the shot up and in. He now has 6 points and a timeout will be taken by Fitch as Canfield's cut what was once a first half 9-point lead down to 2 with 5 minutes 58. Here's a pass to Culp underneath all alone. Puts the shot up and in over Jared Ellis, who came over late. And Culp now has 9 points in the game, and we're tied at 25 with 5:22 to play. Up on the right wing, Kevin Culp looks, throws the ball to Amendola on the left baseline, looks, and bounces the ball back out from here. The quick pass to a cutting Marks to the basket. He scored.
Marks stepped up.
Marks has 2 in the game. 4:38 to play in the third. Canfield leads for the first time in a long time. 20s, and that ends 3 quarters here at Fitch High School. Kind of a ragtag game offensively here, but great defense from both teams. On the right sideline, Anthony Scrocco throws the ball to Culp. Culp to a driving Joel Vertanen, and he gets the easy 2 off the glass. Vertanen has 4 in the game, 34-29. Canfield trails by the Nemens near midfloor, and that gets the Fitch fans unhappy along with Fitch coach Gary Conroy, but that will give it back to Canfield.
You know, even though, you know, I don't take stats, it's sort of ironic. Fitch only has 2 3-point shots.
Marks dribbling the basketball, gives to Kevin Culp at the top of the 3-point arc. He throws the ball up to Amendola. Amendola throws into the circle to Vertanen, down to Culp in the paint, shoots, scores, and fouled.
I tell you, they really have tempo on your defense. Again, people, sometimes people just turn the game on at certain times.
Wing, Marks one-on-one against Croisdale, comes inside the arc, looks and throws the basketball to Amendola at the top of the 3-point arc. Amendola throws it down to Culp, spins, fakes, shoots, and scores.
Every time down, if it doesn't go low to Culp.
The basketball to Amendola, kicks the basketball left corner. Sadie for a 3 across the rim, no good. Offensive rebound, grabbed on the inside, then it's lost, bodies hit the floor. It comes to Vertan, down to Culp, foul.
Did you see that? That really sells the program.
There's a 3-point shot up and good by Anthony Sadie, and a quick timeout by Canfield. They got the ball to Sadie on the left wing. He was left open and he nailed the 3, and it's down to a 2-point
here, up top
lead with 22 seconds to go. And we're talking about how Canfield hadn't hit a 3 all night, but not more opportunistic than their Anthony Sadie, who struggled tonight, knocking one in. Left open on the wing. Fear the game, and this will give Fitch a 3-point lead. Up, good. Fisher is 20, 19 seconds to play, 52-49. Canfield has the ball, trailing by three. Ball swing to Culp on the left wing. Culp outside the three-pointer. He throws the three. He hit it! Kevin Culp has 25. He's tied the game, 5 seconds to play. Here's Russell John into the front court. John left wing. Long three for the win. Annoyed off the rim. And we will go to overtime here at Fitch High School, 52-52. The ball to Amendola on the right wing. Now to Culp at the top, three across the rim. No offensive rim, but Alex Amendola, he put it back in. Amendola with his foot just inside the three-point arc, throws to his twin brother, Zach Amendola. It comes back to the top, three-point shot out the back of the rim. No good. Offensive rim, Mike Herman, he put it back up, he scored. 1:23 to play in overtime. Fitch and Canfield tied at 56.
Kevin Culp pulled the trigger on that again. He's taking about 3 or 4 threes. None bigger than the one he hit.
Wing Ellis dribbles out the final 2 seconds, and that's the end of tonight's game. Good ball game tonight at Austin Town Fitch High School, won by the Fitch Falcons over Canfield, 60-56. Canfield with the loss falls to 12-3. With the victory, Fitch wins their fourth consecutive game and seventh out of their last nine. They go to 8-6 on the season. Again, the final 60-56, a 4-point Fitch win here tonight at home. We'll pause for a timeout. Back to wrap things up after this.
The makeup game at Hickory was not an easy one by any stretch of the imagination. The Cardinals, tired after a tough week, struggled through most of the contest. The shots were not falling for the Cards, and turnovers allowed Hickory to stay within reach of a possible upset. But great athletes never say die. Sadie's hot hand burned the Nets for a season-high 16. But Atkovich finished with 11. The Cards also stayed alive by pulling down 24 rebounds, while Hickory could only muster 14. The Cardinals pulled this one out 47-42.
Everybody in our area, if we just make that kind of commitment, but you can't waste today. You gotta get out there. We're not thinking about the girls' game. We're not thinking about the time of day it is. We're not thinking about how we played last night. We're not thinking about if our legs are a little tough. All we're thinking about is we gotta get better, and this is a team that's in our way. Slide that guard right in a 15-foot gap right in between these two people, okay? Step this guy off, flash this guy in the mid-post right here, and then this guy will be here at the start, and then when the ball gets entered, if the ball gets entered there,
will come down. Now, once in a while, he might be open right there off that penetration, I think.
Games were important battles. Winning all three of these would give the Cardinals a tie for the MAC championship. Each game seemed just as difficult as the last. What sweetened the pot? Well, the players realized that Coach Collin could call this 1998-99 season the season that pushed John Collin into the record books, one of the few coaches in the country to win 300 games. Beating Poland would give Collin his 299th. Kopp led the way against Poland with 19, followed by Varadkovic and Marks with 13, and Sadie with 8. The final, the Cardinals 63, the Bulldogs 55.
Kevin Cho from 3 points.
Quest for number 300 at Salem turned out to be one of the toughest games of the year. But when the dust settled, Kopp had 24, Craig Marks 9, and Collins had his 300th win with a final of 59-57.
Thank you.
When the dust settled, Kopp had 24, Craig Marks 9, and Collins had his 300th win with a final of 59-57.
nationals in Florida this past summer. She is a member of Key Club, White Teams, Young Leaders, National Honor Society, and the airborne staff. Michelle plans to study medicine. She is also an active member of Key Club, White Teams, Young Leaders, and she is the historian of National Honor Society. I would now like to present this year's announcer, the voice of the Cardinals, Joe Lilly. Symphonic bands.
Like this at halftime, but the team that's sitting in here is about 20 points better than the team over there. The only thing is, no one told them. They don't even know. So now we got to go out and prove it to them. Thank God we got 16 more minutes to prove it. We got 16 more minutes to become somebody who is one of the best teams, if not the best team in the area, who just doesn't remember how to act like it. By putting forth effort, staying in your stance for four quarters, by moving the ball and serving each other, by finding the open man, and by dicing them up when they go into that 3-2. They're changing defenses all the time. Have we figured out what to do? What do you do against the 3-2? Tell me. 3-deep. 3-deep. Go at the wing. Make the wing guard you. Kick it to the baseline. Dribble off the baseline. Look for the guy stepping out. Look for the ball in the middle. Or look for the ball over the top. Find the skip zones. But dice them up. Don't stand out there and just dribble at your guy. If your man can guard you in any offense, I don't think too many of them work. And right now, one guy is easily guarding everybody we have. The only guys who went by anybody were our big guys. Now, they didn't pick you up, and that was a nice take to the hoop of the last one. It's a good take because they didn't pick you up, but that would happen a lot if we pushed the ball up the court all the time.
Absolutely.
It would happen a lot. So let's find some people. Get a hand. We got plenty of time. You guys get some time to yourself. I'm not going to chew you out for 50 minutes.
You got
plenty
much left of
Camden. 1, 2, 3, Camden.
Game of the season was a tune-up for the sectionals. The Cards rolled in this one as Kalp scored 15, Vladkovich had 9, and Marks and Sadie added 8 apiece. The season finally was complete. A marvelous 17-3 overall record, John Collins' 301st victory, and a share of the Metro Athletic Conference crown. The Card fans looked with high hopes as the Cardinals prepared for the sectional tournament.
Thank you.
come out?
Starters, yeah.
Starters?
I saw him jump.
Yes.
That wasn't contested. We could throw that anytime we want to. There was nobody. We haven't contested anything yet. Why would they contest that? Now, let's realize that was a total vic that quarter. Total vic. Not many negatives in the whole quarter. Now, one thing about Shaw that you got to learn from him, that was a good move. He likes the in and out move, the in and back move. So when he goes back, you got to close out, but you can't close out of your stance. You just got to be close enough to get a hand in his face, because he shoots the ball from down here in his belly button, but just be close enough to play him. Let's go, guys. Come on. Camping. 1, 2, 3, camping. Hey, what kind of motion restrictions do you have out there, Anthony?
I call it backstream. Camping.
Come on, guys. Let's go. Come on, Ant, think ahead. Z, get your brother. Pegger, get Anthony.
Oh, no.
Come on, Herm, knock him in. Kevin, did you call? Kevin, you call inside motion there? You call inside motion there? Let's see. I want to see one pass away. We're screening. What? Yeah. Come on, Herm. Let's go. Finish it, Mike. Release your hand. Release. Inside! That's the one. Good screen. Hey, we're not getting the inside screens. One pass away, we gotta go get people. Use me, get me. Andy, get some vision. Play terrible defense. That's better. And Mike's tired. Get him the heck out of there. Keep him there, Z. Work him, Z. Work him. Stay down, Anthony. Let's go. Double. Don't let him out of it.
2 minutes left.
There you go, Kev. Kev, it's always right in the middle. He's going right down the gut.
3 for Bixler.
The Cards drew a tough match to open up the tournament. The Southeast Pirates had several players who could shoot threes. Hunt, who hit 90 threes during the season, also had a 40-point game. And Dillon, much the same style shooter, had 36 in a prior contest. But Canfield would not be shaken by past newspaper clippings. The Cards went to work. Canfield scored 24 in the first and 24 in the final stanza to knock off Southeast 80-60. Kalp had 27, Vladkovich and Marks added 12 each, Sadie had 10, Verton an 8, Herman 5, Zach had 4, and Alex added 2. Hunt finished with only 10 points, and Dillon was held to only 12. Collins said, we're back on track. Amendola missed the shot. Offensive rebound to Mike Herman. Puts it back up and ties up the ball game. And by Andy Vlaskovich. He'll go into the forecourt with the basketball. Get it to Amendola on the left wing. Back to Kalp for 3. Top of the key, and he cans it. The rebound. Cracked down in the corner.
by Joel Buchanan, who just checked in there. Hit the cup in the lane. His layup up. His layup good. Boy, Kevin Culp, a man on a mission. Works it on the right side with the basketball. Greg Marks with it. He'll shoot it up from the lane, and he'll hit it. Greg, during the course of the regular season, that's going to make it an 18-14 score. Canfield quickly the other way. Vertanen to Culp inside. Beautiful pass, and Kevin Culp has just tacked on his 13th point of the first quarter. Kevin on the right wing will put up a 22-footer off the rim. Rebound inside to Marks. Puts it back up, and Craig Marks with his fourth point. 2-16 ball game. Marks will put it up left side from 12 out, and Craig Marks with the hot hand. He's in with 6 points. Heading in the quarter. Into the forecourt. Shot partially blocked. Picked up by Vladkovich. Puts it up too late from three-point land, and that is the end of the first quarter. So a wild and woolly first quarter. Anthony Sadie to Vladkovich from 12 out. He'll hit his first 2 points of the game. So Andy Vladkovich, who comes in averaging 16 per ball game, with his first two, back the other way for the quick layup. Alex Amendole with the basketball. He'll work it on the right wing to Herman inside the call. Comes back out to Vladkovich, open for three, and he cans it. Sadie can't get the shot off. To Kevin Culp, right side it goes to Vladkovich. His three up again is perfect. Vladkovich out front, he'll work it on the left side to Craig Marks. Fakes right, goes left, goes into the baseline. Gets a beautiful pick by Vertanen, and he'll go in for the layup. Here's Marks with the basketball. Turnover number 8 for the Southeast Pirates. Dump off pass, right baseline, wide open Vertanen for the, and the rebound to Canfield, and there is the horn, indicating the end of the first half. Wild and woolly one. Vladkovich will pull up at the free throw line, and Andy Vladkovich will count his 10th point of the ball game. There they go. Back out front to Anthony Sadie. Sadie top of the key, he'll launch the three and bank it in. Whoa, high ball game. Here's Sadie, forecourt, 2-on-1, into the lane, banks it up and drops it in. Vertanen inside the call, tipped away, and Kevin will track it down right in front of the Canfield bench. Now here's what John Collin wants to happen. Inside feet to Vertanen, and they pay it up with the Kevin Culp. Up quickly, forecourt, Vertanen inside, layup good. Looks it to the left side, double team, goes over to Craig Marks on the left wing. Marks looks inside to Vertanen, back to Culp, he'll drive into the lane, power move is good for two. A little bit of frustration on the part of Hunt. Quickly to Vertanen, drives in for the layup. Good with a little bit of trouble against the press, but they'll get it into the forecourt. Vladkovich will pull up from 14 on the left side and hit it. Hunt into the forecourt with 5 seconds. Gets it on the left side. Back at front to Seaman. His three-pointer is perfect at the buzzer. Jim Seaman in the scorebook for the first time. Here's a man that lay on the left wing to Sadie inside the Culp against Seaman. Shot up and shot in. Hey, by Hunt, re-stolen away by Kevin Culp. Job with the basketball inside to Vladkovich for the play next or this Saturday. Here's the mid-side feed to Culp as Kevin comes in quickly. Vladkovich out to Marks, and now John Collin's going to pull it out and go with a semi-stall. Here's Marks. He's going to drive inside. Left-handed layup got it. Points for Dillon. Canfield lead at 8, 66-58, going against full court pressure. Here's Marks into the forecourt, breaks the press, goes to the free throw line, gives it to Culp, bounce pass, layup good. Greg Marks with another great feed, and Kevin Culp now in with 26 points by Vladkovich. Full court pass to Amendola, goes in for the layup and gets it. Lieutenant, left wing to Marks, high post to Herman. We're down to 45 seconds remaining fourth quarter in Canfield. Really, what a well coached ball club there as Mike Herman was taken down on
the old arm take down.
Yeah.
Basketball.
On the left wing with the basketball as Canfield works it down to 5-4. DeMaglio in the corner, inside feed to Mike Herman, and he'll put in the layup at the buzzer, and it will count. So the final score from the Boardman High School Fieldhouse is Canfield moves to the sectional final Saturday. The Cardinals 80, Southeast 60. Field was next. If Canfield could beat this team and get by Cheney, they knew they would have another crack at Struthers. It began as a shooting battle, but Field quickly cooled. Kalp and Vladkovich remained hot throughout the entire contest. Before the final horn, Kalp had mastered enough points to place another record in the books. The prior record of 37 points in one game was now history. Kalp finished with 40, including 5 3-pointers. Vladkovich finished with 21, and Skrocko added 8. The team shot 63% overall. Kalp said it was simply a team effort. A team record and another sectional championship for Coach John Collin.
2 minutes remaining first quarter. Vladkovich misses on the three. Sadie tracks down the long rebound. Inside the Kalp from the lane for two more. Kevin Kalp in with 11. Timeout on the court. Perry was here. He didn't know if he was Greek or not. Here we go. Vladkovich for three. Got it. Throwing it to 16-13 ball game. Vladkovich for three more. No. Rebound 5-4. Picked up by Marks in the paint. Up and in. And let's see if Canfield will play for the last shot. Yeah, John Cullen hollering at the ball club. They'll pull it out. Left side, Vladkovich with 5 seconds for three, and he buries it. Andy Vladkovich with his second triple, and there's the horn indicating the end of the first quarter. The quarter where Field started off with the initial burst, but it was Canfield really coming on strong from about the six-minute mark till the end of the quarter after one the score. The Cardinals 20, the Field Falcons 13. Will be back. That's another new face in there for Field as Kevin Kopp unloads from the left wing outside the arc and drills the three. 3-17 score. Roberts now with 6. Here's Kopp inside for 2 more. The basketball. That's Attic. So go deep on but up baseline to Mike Herman. Back out front. Now inside the Kopp. Layup up. Good. They cannot stop Kevin Kopp here tonight in the first half. 21. But Adkovich inside the arc. Gets it over to Craig Marks, right wing. The Kalp for three, got it! He is sizzling, folks. 21 points for Kevin Kalp, and the inbound thrown out of bounds by the Field Falcons.
Now outside, it comes to Anthony Sadie. And Vladkovich inside the arc and hits the 16-footer.
Vladkovich for Canfield. Vladkovich into the forecourt, the Kalp up and in, and he's fouled. That ball hung on the lip and then fell through. And Kevin Kalp continues his monster first half here at the Boardman High School. Gonna hit it here in the first half. Barney S, 25. Now 20, is that 25? He's at 26. The forecourt, left side to Kalp for three off the back of the rim. Rebound 5-4. Picked up by Andy Vladkovich. Back doors it to Kevin Kalp for two more.
Here's to Mike Herman, left wing to Skrocko. Skrocko out front. Marks is going to put up the runner with 2 seconds left. He'll miss it. Rebound and up, and that will be the buzzer indicating the end of the first half. Herman with his second board of the ball game. Go back the other way. Here's a Mendeley from the left wing, right inside the arc. Move into the forecourt. Left side, Anthony Sadie. He'll drive into the paint. Kick it over to Amandelay. Alex to Herman. Right baseline into Vladkovich. Driving. Layup puts it up with a left hand and it falls in. The forecourt, right side. Canfield leading by 12. Vladkovich left side, the Kalp head fake, and he'll put it up, he'll put it in, and he'll draw the foul. And it's good. Danny Roberts with 16.
15 feet, that's his range, and knocks him home.
Backdoor feed from Vladkovich to Amandelay, couldn't quite find it. And backboard, the Cardinals with 4:17 remaining in the third quarter. Get it into Vladkovich, a 16-quarter perfect. One ball game. Marks into the forecourt. Marks to the baseline. Out front to Anthony Sadie. He'll drive into the paint. Dump it off to Burton. Inside layup good. Nice banner. Marks will walk it into the forecourt. Right side. The cup for three, and he throws it from the right wing. 35 for Kevin Culp, 56 for the Cardinals, 41 for Field. Rebound Craig Marks. Marks quickly, three on one. He'll dump it off. Andy Varadkovich for the easy layup. And the Cardinals suddenly up by 17. Wasn't it a couple of 30 seconds ago? They're up by 8. And Conant, right wing, will drill it. Antwood now up by 17. And a steal by Amandre. Picked up by his brother. Here's Zach on the drive and hammered as he goes in for the layup. And he came down hard on that right shoulder. Actually, it's the right wrist of Alex Amandre, or that's Zach Amandre. Zach is walking over toward John Collin, and John says, well, get up there at the line and try it. You can substitute in this situation, but you're going to take Amandre out of there. Now one of the officials going over to look at him, and again, Zach going over toward the bench. He came down hard on that right wrist. And they're going to send in Andy Varadkovich as Zach Amandre goes to the far end of the bench, and here comes the trainer for Canfield. Alex Amandre back to Varadkovich, top of the key to Vertanen. Kevin Cobb getting the breather right now, by the way. Gets it over to Skrocko for three, and he drove it. Anthony Skrocko in the books for the first time. Knocked out of his game. In the Cardinals. Skrocko, right side, Varadkovich, layup good, and he drew the foul. Andy Varadkovich with 19. Rounding up, I think that's his third putback tonight. He's in with 14. That's going to make it a 68-50 score. Three-pointer by Sadie, left wing, perfect. Fourth quarter, steal by Varadkovich. Andy into the forecourt. Andy on the drive. Andy on the layup, and he got it. Here's Varadkovich. Oh, low look pass to Sadie. Anthony almost lost it. Gets it over to Kopp for three. Got it. 38 for Kevin Kopp. There's in there for Campion. Craig Marks, one of them. He'll drive to Kopp. Layup, no good, and he got hammered. Nick Tikas going to pick up his football only. Andy Varadkovich leaving. Kevin Kopp hits the front end. He has 39. Standing ovation for Varadkovich. He gets his 40th point. Yes, he did. He has 40. He's out of there. He'll get a standing ovation. 40 tonight, and he's out of the ball game with Canfield 78-52 lead, and they're still giving him an ovation even though the play has resumed. That's driving in for the layup and putting it in. Anthony Skrocko with a great play on both ends. He's here, and Thursday will probably be back here. Up, good. Joe Glista in the books for the first down. Plays it for the Falcons. That's Aaron Embacher. Glista inside, missed the shot, gets his own rebound, up and in for Joe Glista. Glista with three here. Throw is perfect. 85-56. Into the forecourt, Skrocko to Craig Marks. Shot blocked by Embacher in the buzzer. And that is the horn.
And they get the look at another game field victory. 85-56, the final put this in the win column for the 303rd time in the career of Canfield head coach John Cullen. The Cardinals bring to the district. Final score, 85-56. We'll be back to tell you how it happened. The coach taking a pass for this message. Say it.
The Cards on the whole did not mesh as well in their final game against the Cheney Cowboys. Cheney's Mike Moses scored 23, and no one else for the Cowboys hit double figures. Kalvin Vladkovich fought hard to keep the season alive, but fell just short in this one, 49-45. Our two seniors were our horses all season long, said Coach Cullen. They brought us a long way. They are two great ball players. They give us a challenge for next year.
Okay. Out of the corner, thinking about coming in the baseline. Blakovich quick to get back on the defense. Moses now comes in the right baseline, spin move right of the paint. He's going to be guilty of a travel. He kind of stumbled before he put the shot up, and that'll give the ball back to Canfield. That ball up along the right side across the line to Culp. In the paint, they will find Craig Marks. His shot up no good. Marks with his own rebound puts it back up and in. Going back to Marks. Floyd out the defender. He'll bring it in. Stop short of the paint. Go back outside to Culp. Culp right side to a mid layup. Down in the wing to Blakovich. Launches the high arcing three, and it's good. Marks thought about the three. Moses out there to defend him. He'll turn it over to Amendolea. Back to Milakovic. Pops it from the free throw line. No good. Rebound. Amendolea back off the glass. It in. Get to Milakovic. Has the ball swatted in the air. Floyd comes up with it. Goes up with a shot. Body to a foul. No. Marks comes down with a rebound. He'll bring it in the paint. Kick it right side to Burton. And on the baseline. It's good. And a timeout. Head coach Tim Mullally. 13-7, Canfield with the lead, 1:55 on the opening period. Back to Boardman after this on the fan, 1240 WBBW. Right wing to Sadie. Sadie working against Andrews. Holds the ball above his head. He'll take it up top to Burton. Burton, left side of Milakovic. Down low to Marks. Thought about the long two. Now he'll step inside a defender and pop one. Still was a pretty long two. It gives him four in the contest.
Canfield heads the other way. Sadie has the ball now, looks at Burton, checks himself, gets it off to Blackovich. Blackovich two in the air, good. Back here in Boardman has the ball, picked up by Canfield. Canfield gets an inbounds, Blackovich. Blackovich over to Herman. Herman puts a shot off the glass, good. Almost stolen away by Hairston. Gives it off to Herman. Herman to Culp. Culp in the block once again, spins in lane, puts up a shot, rolls around the rim, good. Now Mendeley in the left wing puts a shot off the glass. No good. Culp with the rebound. Puts it back up again. No good. A rebound by Harris. Harris and a good job by Culp. It puts Harris with the turnaround jumper. No good. A rebound by Herman. Herman to Blackovich. Blackovich quickly out to Mendeley. He puts the shot up. Good. Gets it off to Moses. Moses pulls up. Goes baseline with it. Puts the shot up. And goes. Moses hangs high in the air. Shoots over two guys. And the shot falls. Now the other way. A shot at half court.
Everybody take a charge, so just get out of the way. And first of all, the guy's a good player. He's a good spinner. He spins on us every time, and we don't have anybody helping take away the driving lanes. There's very little togetherness out there at all. But terrible job of defense, and they got 13 easy points. Now, not on our fast break. You guys got back, did a nice job. We did a terrible job of doing this. Coming to meet the passes. Where is it? Come and get it. We're not coming to get it. We're just coming out and we're giving them. We're not coming at an angle to cut down the angle of the pass. We're coming out just hoping we get it.
Herman looking for someone, gets it off to Sadie. Sadie now to Culp. Culp in the block. He's going to move, go baseline with it, put the shot up, gets it. Up in tonight's game as the second shot up and good. Finding Culp in the offense here in the second half. Now they get it off to Herman. Herman in the block. Gets it back out. Sadie, three in the air. Good. Burton and the Marks.
It might be something. Could it try me again?
Yeah, don't come in here with that. Now Sadie has the ball, gets it to Culp. Culp back to Sadie. Really trying to get Andrews. Culp steals it away. Now quickly down court to Sadie. Sadie puts a layup off. Good. Up the basketball. Gets it into Blackmidge. Blackmidge in the lane. Puts the shot off the glass. No good. Rebound by Marks. Marks. He could tie it up once again for about the fifth time. Off to Blackmidge. Blackmidge three in the air. No good. And the shot wouldn't have counted even if it did go. And we are at the end of the third quarter here in Boardman. And just like the
line stopped short of the paint. Wanted to bounce it up on the stripe to Harris. And the ball picked out of there by Sadie. Now he loses it. Still loose on the court. Goes out of bounds. And last touch as an animated call by the official gives it back to the Cheney Cowboys. Up at the free throw line, loses the basketball, picked up by Culp. Culp up ahead to amend the layup. And the running right-hander is going to be goaltended by one of the Cowboys. So count the bucket. Dishes right side, three in the air by Moses. It's good. No, they'll say two. His foot was on the line, and Moses nails the long range two to bring the Cowboys within one. Canfield 41, Cheney 40.
Moses had a good look, and he just moved his foot a little bit, just to touch the line, giving that ball the 2-point shot.
Burton with a basketball. He wants to go in the paint to Culp. He leads him too far. Culp able to save it over to Amendolea. Amendolea back up top outside to Lakovic. Guarded by Anthony Floyd. He'll go right wing to Burton. 4:23 and counting. Canfield with a 1-point advantage in the basketball. Over to Sadie. Trying to come to the left side. Double team. Kicks it back outside to Culp. Culp, top of the circle to Burton. Down low on the right side to Amendolea. And he'll go back up top to Anthony Sadie. Thought about the three and Moses out there to defend him. Sadie turning around. Moses all over him. Able to get the ball over to Kevin Culp. 4 minutes and counting. Culp with a basketball. Down to Burton and up top to Sadie. Thought about the three once again, and once again Moses out to defend him.
Sadie. Yeah, but spreading it out, getting the right shot, making sure that you're going to be wide open before you take this shot.
Sadie with a basketball. Moses with the defense. And a timeout called by head coach John Cullen and the Canfield Cardinals. 20-second timeout. 3 points by Sean Armstrong.
Was out of bounds. Canfield gets the ball back though with 3 minutes left.
41-40, 1-point lead for the Cardinals. They're set to inbound the ball, going up top to Culp. Culp guarded by Andrews. Culp back in the paint to Burton. And Burton back outside to Culp. 4-3. It rattles around, falls off the side. No good. Huh? Canfield fans.
Hello,
Pat.
The area is open either from Bible Loom replacement windows.
Three in the air by Vlakovic. Nothing but net and a timeout called by the Canfield Cardinals.
Andy Vlakovic will go on to Grove City College on a full 4-year scholarship. His accolades included third team All-Northeastern Ohio, first team All-Metro Athletic Conference. Kevin Culp will go to Westminster College on a full 4-year scholarship. His honors included first team All-Northeastern Ohio, first team All-Metro Athletic Conference, All-State Special Mention, Mahoning Coaches Association All-Beach Classic, All-Star, and Coach John Cullen was once again Metro Athletic.